my gangsta girl t-shirt on. We are on the east side. Well, you say long over there? You got something longer than 5 minutes? All right, we'll check you later. So I used to work for this company that start drug testing. I know. But I was excited. So I thought, this is my chance to climb the corporate ladder. I'm going to run over there to HR and volunteer to go first. So I walk over to the HR office and approach the manager. And I said, I want to be the first one to start drug testing. And he looked at me all confused, like, what? I've heard rumors about you. In fact, I heard you're a very vocal advocate for the legalization of marijuana. I said, I know. This is part of my experience. I survived the 70s, fool. I know about acid, shrooms, crack, cocaine, hash, opium. Take me to the drug room. Let the testing begin. Give me the drugs. Well, apparently that's not what he meant. I was sent back to my desk. While I was in the bathroom, an anonymous brown box showed up on my desk with a pink piece of paper in there, secretly delivered. I opened it up, took out the paper, licked it a couple times, thinking it was blotter acid. Maybe they changed their mind. No, I was fired. Fired! Not even on my day off. Apparently, they wanted to drug test me. Well, I'm not down with that, people. What I do on my time is my business. Yeah. Nacho. Yeah. Nacho business. Besides, I don't take drugs at work. It's because of work I take drugs. Speaking of drugs, I watched this documentary the other night about marijuana addiction. This bitch on there was saying after smoking it every week for 3 years, she got addicted. 3 years! I said, well, that's great news. I've only been an addict for 7 years instead of 10. And some other crazy girl on there was saying, after she smoked it regularly for a few years, she stopped. And after 2 years of not smoking it, she had a psychotic breakdown. Right. She ended up taking all these powerful drugs that made her hallucinate, and she joined the frickin' circus. I said, for fuck's sake, you might as well keep smoking the weed. At least the harmful effects of that are just eating and sleeping. Y'all do that anyway. But I'm really just up here trying to make my parents proud. I love them. I'm very grateful to them. Some of y'all may not know this, but I was adopted. And I cannot be any more thankful for them rescuing me out of the wilds of Kanata. It's Canada for you crackers who don't know what I'm talking about. We're very close, and I can talk to them about anything. For example, the other night, me and my dad were having a little conversation, and he goes, yeah, I was at the doctor the other day, and they found a lump. I said, what kind of lump they find in your neck? He said, not there, lower. I said, oh, well, wouldn't you think mom would have found that? He said, your mother doesn't do that anymore. I said, well, Dad, it's probably just built up then. You got an internet, a credit card? Handle it, Pops. One day I was in the bedroom, which is next to theirs. I was probably six. And I heard my mom say, you know, Jim, that's my dad, I think we probably should have went for an exorcism over that baptism we did. Because it doesn't seem to be having any effect on her. You know, she resembled that side. And not knowing any of my birth parents, and I know I didn't look like any bitches I was in that family with, she meant the dark side. But okay, I was proud of myself, even when she wasn't.
All right!
It's Christmas in July.
Yes.
It is Christmas in July.
Christmas tree.
Some trifling things went down in 2006. Another true story, y'all ready?
Ready.
Are y'all ready?
Yeah.
All right. I'm big. I need big reaction, okay? It was the night before Christmas and Santa was hard. He was fixing to lube up that bitch Miss Claus real hard. Her pussy was old and he had to revive it. And clean it up good if he's going inside it. He got out the Crisco, the gloves, and the shop vac. Told that bitch to get on her back. When what to his crust-filled eyes did he see? Some shit that scared him so bad it made him pee. A line of elves came out of her hole with a wave and said, "Is it time to stop hibernating in this cave?" "Hibernate," Santa said. "I thought y'all were dead. Come out that muff so I can get me some head." The elves ran off just a slipping and sliding, but not from the snow. Remember where they were hiding? The smell of stank snatch fogged up the North Pole. "Forget it, Santa hollered. I ain't touching that hole." Miss Claus was mad and didn't understand why Santa would rather have sex with his hand. He said, "It's cleaner and smaller and much more tight. Besides, my gloves are already white." So once again this year, Miss Claus did been laid. But there's some holes in the road about to get paid. Merry Christmas to all. I mean that from me. Don't know what Santa's giving, but he's getting an STD. Thank you. All right, one more break. 5 minutes. My last set. We're at the lake. Y'all bitches holler.
All right. Thank you.